determined, I laughed out loud, because I am not that mother. I am the mother who, if I see there are only 4 pieces of pie and 5 people, I start to think of, should I wait till the other people leave? Should I put the kids to bed and then we can share the pie just amongst the adults? But I am not one to easily give up my piece of pie. And so when I see a quote like this, I have to be honest, I begin to question myself as a mother. I begin to even question my worth as a person. How dare I not be willing to sacrifice everything for those other people? I mean, I can even go so far as questioning my role as a pastor. Aren't I the person the pastor is supposed to be, the person who gives the most? Aren't I the woman, the mother, the pastor supposed to sacrifice myself as Jesus did for others? Aren't I supposed to be the most like Jesus? But wait, hold on. Isn't that a little bit presumptuous to think that I am more Jesus-like than someone else who has the love of God within them? I mean, I, in all honesty, I'm willing to let other people be like Jesus as long as I get a piece of pie. I mean, all I really wanted was a piece of pie. And now all of a sudden from these moments, I feel guilty and confused, and I start to think I haven't even gotten pie yet, and maybe it really is just easier to sacrifice my piece of pie for others. But is it right? You see, every once in a while, there's another quote. I see it float around the social media circle, and it says this. Children shouldn't have to sacrifice so that you can have the life you want. You make sacrifices so your children can have the life they deserve. Well, when I start to think about this quote in relation with the pie quote, I start to even have more questions. Because now I can't eat the pie, and they use that big word, sacrifice, which is a theological and deeply faithful word. Therefore, if I really do eat the pie, I'm not all of a sudden living in faithful relationship to the other people around me, and most importantly, my children whom I love. So, while both of these quotes and thoughts and ideas are well-intentioned, I always find myself questioning whether they are really helpful and healthy for people in relationship with multi-generations in a faith-based world. Is giving up a piece of pie, giving up what one wants in life, and sacrificing, is that all of these images, is that actually what God wants? Now we know I want a piece of pie, so maybe I'm trying to find a way around this loophole just so I can get a piece of pie. But I promise I've really started to think this whole pie analogy, sacrificing children thing through. And I started to recognize that we also have to know that sacrifice is a big theological word. And as we talked about, it means offering. Because God probably doesn't really care if I have a pie or you have a pie, but God does care what we offer to God. And God has said again So if you hear no other part of my sermon today, think about these in comparison. Self-deprivation as being celebrated over community possession and responsibility. Often we see on Mother's Day that our focus is mom-focused as the individual, not mothering-focused as a community and society. So instead, I think faithfully, instead of using singular pronouns, what happens if all of a sudden we use plural pronouns? When we look at holidays like today, and we start to think about what we truly are able to offer and sacrifice as faithful people of God. My reflection on this second quote were written in a blog that I wrote a few years before I began even working here. And the article I wrote actually highlighted what my mother and father taught me and what I have come to see as a more faithful response. And so I wanted to share that with you today. There's my mom and my dad. One of the best teachings my parents taught me was that they were not giving up their lives for me. Instead, they were enjoying their lives more because of me. I was a part of the life they wanted. Their lives did not end because I was around. Their lives changed in some ways, but many situations caused life to change because, well, that's life. My parents still travel, sometimes with me and sometimes without me. They still worked hard and at times were too busy for me. But at times, however, I became too busy for them. And when we were all together, I knew we all wanted to be together and that we were invested in each other. The life my parents wanted me to have did not end all of a sudden when I had children. My life was not over or sacrificed, even if the amount of sleep I needed had ended. Just as my parents wanted or want me to have the life I deserve, I want my children to have the life they deserve. I would shortchange them if I thought they got everything by my own sacrifice or their father's. Instead, I want to be an example to show them you don't always get what you want. But with hard work, faith, and strong people around you, there is much that can be done. I want my children to know that life can be short and powerful, or long and lasting. I want them to know life is not about others having to lose for gain, but finding ways for all to gain and be enriched. So today's scripture from this Mother's Day connects this. It comes from the prophet Isaiah, and Wendell Berry noted that Isaiah uses the past tense to refer to God and the actions of God, but the present tense verbs quickly demand that the past images be let go, and that our focus truly become on new images and new ideas and new imaginative ways to, well, do what adults usually should teach their children to do, but we sometimes forget as adults, and that is share. Figure out another way, a new way beyond just the mind way. I mean, the Israelites in the scripture currently have a very small piece of pie, and most of the pie has been given to the Babylonians. But God, through Isaiah, is saying, do not be afraid. Remember, I can do something new. I renamed Jacob to Israel, and I know your names, and I can do something new through you. Everyone can still figure out a way sacrificial things, but we are people who know that God knows our names and finds us on the other side. And none of this, none of us inside this place and outside, need to get stuck with the preconceived images and limitations. Because we know a Jesus Christ who has overcome those limitations in his life, in his death, and in his resurrection. He fulfilled the words of the prophets like Isaiah, and we are the ones to continue to live and do new things with that knowledge. God has faith in us and knows us by name in every generation and entitles us and wants us to bring our best. Not feelings of guilt or less than, but feelings of gratefulness and the knowledge that we know a God that can make a way in the wilderness. We know a God that has given us the ability to make a way for other people, even when it so often seems that there is not enough. So this is what I've discovered. I will take you all with me. Hello, we're walking. This is the communion table, for those of you who are traveling via the internet. And while you can't see it, here's a piece of pie. And if I tried to feed this pie to everyone in here in the pieces and the images of what a pie is supposed to look like, well, the reality is not everyone here would get pie. But I'm a mother who likes a mess. And thus, I'm going to just divide that pie right up. Right over there, make it a crumble. That's the fancy name, right? If you can't make a good pie, you make a good crumble. And now, if I mix it up, and if I hand out the 48 spoons that I have in the pack, then today during communion, everyone can have a piece of pie. Everyone can share in knowing the love of what it means to be a mother. And so what I really have discovered as I thought about this image all week is I am the type of mother and pastor who loves to make a big mess. I love to live in the messiness that is truly what it means to be a mom, a human, a person, that life is messy. And sometimes when we mush it all together and we make it a crumble, that is actually the opportunity that God has been waiting for to make something new. And it's the messiest moments in life, and the messiest relationships with our families, and the messiest mom or dad or mom